Hello everyone, welcome to this new video on rendering an RDLC report in an ASP.NET Core application. An RDLC report is an XML-based file that contains the report layout, parameters, and other report-related information. RDLC reports are designed to pass data reports from applications. We need to set four items to render an RDLC report in the ASP.NET Report Viewer. The reporting service. This service is used to interact with server-side report processing. The processing mode. This option specifies whether to process the report in local or remote mode. The reports will be processed as RDL if the processing mode is set to remote and RDLC if it is set to local. The report path. This option is used to set the path of the report that we are going to render in the ASP.NET Report Viewer. The data sources. These are used to assign the required data to the report. First, I'll create a new ASP.NET Core web application. I open Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project. I choose ASP.NET Core Web Application Model View Controller. And then I click Next. I change the project name and click Next. For this demo, I set the target framework as .NET 6.0. The Bold Reports ASP.NET Core Report Viewer works in ASP.NET Core 2, ASP.NET Core 3, and ASP.NET Core 5.0 versions. I click Create. The new ASP.NET Core web application will be created. Next, let me install the necessary NuGet packages in the application. In the Solution Explorer tab, I right-click the project and choose Manage NuGet Packages. In the Browse tab, I search for the boldreports.aspnet.core package and install it in the core application. In the same way, I install the boldreports.net.core. I'll explain the purpose of each package. The boldreports.aspnet.core package creates a client-side reporting control using tag helpers. The boldreports.net.core package creates a web API service to process the reports. The dependent packages will be installed automatically on installing the boldreports.net.core package. Next, I need to reference the scripts and CSS to render the report viewer control. In this video, I am using CDN links to reference scripts and the style sheet. You can also use local scripts and themes. I have included an FAQ link for them in the description for this video. I open the layout.cshtml page in the views/shared folder. I copy the necessary scripts from the documentation and add them in the head tag. This documentation link is also available in the description for this video. Next, I configure the script manager. I copy this code and replace the code in the body tag. The bold script manager in the body element places the report viewer control initialization script in the web page. In order to initialize the scripts properly, the script manager should be included at the end of the body element. Next, I open the viewimports.cshtml file from the views folder and initialize the report viewer component with tag helper support. The next step is to initialize the report viewer. For that, I open the index.cshtml file from the home folder. Then, I remove the existing code and add this code. The ID attribute specifies the unique name for the report viewer component. For this demo, I assign the value viewer to the ID attribute. Next, I create a folder named resources in the www root folder of my application. This is where we will keep the RDLC reports. For this video, I am going to add the productlist.rdlc file to the resources folder. You will find the productlist.rdlc file link in the video description. Next, I create a class file named productlist.cs in the application root folder. I copy the code from the documentation and paste it inside the productlist class. Next, we need to configure the web API. The ASP.NET Core Report Viewer requires a web API service to process the RDL, RDLC, and SSRS report files. I create a new controller file and name it reportviewercontroller.cs inside the controller folder. In the controller file, I add the necessary using statement. In the root attribute, I add the action placeholder. And I remove the API controller attribute. Then I inherit iReportController. I copy the necessary variables and methods from the documentation and paste them inside the reportViewerController class. In the onInitReportOptions method, first I set the value for processing mode to local. Next, I need to load the report as a stream. To do that, I create a variable named basePath and assign the folder path value that has the report. Then, I combine the basePath with the report path sent from index.cshtml. Next, I create an instance for the file stream and assign the file path to it. I create the memory stream and copy the file stream value to it. Then, I assign the report stream value to the reportOption.reportModel.stream variable. I add the data value collection to the data source value. Here, name is case sensitive, and it should be the same as the data source name in the report definition. The value accepts iList, dataset, and data table inputs. Next, I register the license token to remove the license validation message. In this demo, I am going to use the online license token. License tokens can be generated in the subscription section of the Bold Reports Accounts page. I open the program.cs file and enter the code snippet to register the license token. I have provided the link to a video on registering a license using online license tokens and offline license keys in this video's description. Let's move on to showing the productlist.rdlc with the report viewer. I open the index.cshtml page and first set the report service URL. This URL specifies the service URL in which the report viewer service is hosted. Then, I set the value for report path and view report click. Then I copy the onView report click method from the documentation and add it in the index.cshtml. I save the file. And now everything is ready to render the RDLC report from the ASP.NET Core application. I build and run the application. You can see the report is loaded in the browser. You can also bind the data source in the Razor page. In the reportViewerController.cs file, I remove the reportOption.reportModel.datasources add line and save the file. Then, I open the homeController.cs file. I create an object for the reportDataSource class. I assign the data source name as the value of the report data source.name. And the value that needs to be rendered is assigned to report data source.value. Then, I assign the report data source object to the viewBag.datasources. I save the file. In the index.cshtml file, I add the data source's value in the bold report viewer tag. I save the file. I build and run the application. you can see the report is loaded in the browser. In this video, we saw how to create an ASP.NET Core application, how to reference the required scripts to render an RDLC report, and how to declare the variables to bind the data source from the Web API controller and with RazorViews to render the report. I have provided a documentation link in the description below for the steps that we followed in this video. I have also provided a link to our article on enabling image rendering with the report viewer on Linux and other non-Windows platforms for your reference. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.